Ladies and gentlemen, from our nation's capital, please welcome the United States Army Band Pershing Zone under the baton of their leader and commander, Colonel Timothy J. Holton. States Army Band Pershing Zone have been the premier musical representatives of America's Army. Through music, they have shared the story of our nation and its soldiers worldwide. We welcome you to this performance on behalf of all of the men and women of the Army, for they are the strength of our nation. Ready today and prepared for tomorrow. Would you please stand and join in the singing of our national anthem?
Thank you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome. I'm Master Sergeant Dave Brown, your announcer for this evening's grand concert, which culminates our 33rd annual Tuba Euphonium Workshop here at Brucker Hall. We opened our concert with a march written by Major Scott McKenzie and dedicated to his classmates at the U.S. Army Command and General Staff College, the Iron Majors. Next, we turn to the music of Sir William Walton in a march composed for the planned coronation of King Edward VIII in May 1937. Walton was not the presumptive choice for such an honor, but the recent death of Edward Elgar passed the pen to Walton, who was considered next in the line of British musical heritage. Of course, the coronation itself also included a stand-in after Edward VIII proposed marriage to American socialite Wallace Simpson just months before, causing a constitutional crisis. Edward eventually abdicated. The coronation did take place as scheduled with the crowning of his younger brother, King George VI. After the ceremony, music critics were not kind to Walton, complaining that his new march was unrepresentative of his style, that it had a boring bass line, and was therefore unlikely to survive. Well, the critics were wrong. Walton's march did survive, becoming the music of choice for the 1953 coronation of Queen Elizabeth II. And those of you who got up early on an April morning in 2011 will remember that this march was the regal backdrop for Prince William and Catherine Middleton as they recessed hand in hand down the aisle of Westminster Abbey, followed by the Queen and the royal family in beauty bearing the crown imperial. Thank you. That was fun. I wish you could have all been up here to join in on that. Well, a famous T.S. Eliot quote reads, "We shall not cease our exploration, and at the end of all of our exploring, we will arrive where we started and know the place for the very first time." Our next soloist started his exploration right here at Brucker Hall way back in 1981 when he joined the Army Band as a euphonium player. A couple of years later, he performed as a featured soloist here on this stage at the very first Tuba Euphonium Conference. In 1989, he took a hiatus from the band to pursue a civilian career, and he came back to us in 2002. Tonight marks his final performance in uniform after a career that has spanned 35 years and ends right where it began, at a spot that Eliot would say he now knows for the first time. For his final performance, he has chosen a staple of solo euphonium repertoire, first compiled by master performer Simone Mandia. Ladies and gentlemen, Lieutenant Richard Hennebry now takes the podium to conduct Fantasy Original, performed by our very own Master Sergeant Neil Corwell.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, it's hard to believe that it's been 10 years since a young tuba student left the University of Michigan to join the Philadelphia Orchestra, becoming not only the youngest member of the orchestra, but the first female tuba player in a major symphony. Since that time, her impact on the tuba world has been quite remarkable, as she has trailblazed a path and inspired a brand new generation of tuba players around the world. Now, we first tried to feature her with the concert band back in 2010, but many of you probably remember we had to cancel that concert due to Snowmageddon. So this year, we outsmarted Mother Nature, and we moved this workshop 1 week later in the calendar and dodged the blizzard of 16, and we are thrilled that that worked out for us. Now, tonight, she's going to perform a very popular tuba solo. The original version was written for tuba and piano in 1978, and she actually had the honor of premiering the orchestral version when she was 18 years old. As the story goes, she auditioned to be a part of the Henry Mancini Institute, and the director, Patrick Williams, was so impressed with her audition that he asked her to play a concerto with the festival orchestra at the Institute that summer in Los Angeles. Williams suggested something like a horn concerto, but Carol thought a tuba concerto would be a better idea. She told Williams she wanted to play the Broughton tuba concerto, but it doesn't have an orchestral accompaniment. Patrick Williams said, "Bruce Broughton?" She said, "Yeah." He said, "Hold on." Pulled out his phone and called. By the end of the phone call, Broughton not only had agreed to rescore the parts for orchestra, he cleared his calendar in order to conduct the premiere himself with Carol performing. Ladies and gentlemen, it is our great honor to welcome Carol Yonch.
The Thank you.
Next up, we'd like to feature the principal euphonium player in the Army Band and also our workshop chairman, Sergeant Major Don Pallmeyer. Tonight, he performs a relatively new addition to the euphonium playbook, which has quickly become one of the instrument's most performed solo works. Now, tonight, you're going to hear three movements. First, the juggler, which immediately establishes a sense of fun, graphically bringing to mind both the ease of movement and lolloping suspense of the juggler's art. The second movement is titled Romanza, and it includes an instruction to play romantically. Makes sense? I wish I had more on that. I don't, I'm sorry. The final movement is the traditional Russian troika, which imitates the prancing of horses, complete with jingle sleigh bells, and leads to a cadenza of great brilliance followed by a rousing conclusion. Ladies and gentlemen, performing Carl Jenkins' Euphonium Concerto, please give a warm welcome to Sergeant Major Don Pallmeyer.
Thank you. Thank you.
We'd like to bring Sergeant Major Paul Meyer back out. Give him a round of applause here. Don't go anywhere. Many of you may not know that Don's military career began way back in 1980 when he joined the Marine Corps Recruit Depot Band. Where was that? Paris Island, South Carolina. That means you went through the real Marine Corps basic training? All right. Oorah. In 1987, Don decided to upgrade and moved on to the President's Own United States Marine Band. And in 1994, he joined us here at the Army Band. He is our principal euphonium player. He also has served as a brass group leader in the concert band and also the concert band element leader, which is not an easy job. And in 2007, he became chairman of this workshop. And I can tell you that the way this workshop has been run, how we run it, how we pay for it, how we schedule it, pretty much everything about it has changed in the years that Don has run this workshop. And knowing what I know about what he has done to keep this thing alive, it certainly would not be here, as great as it is, if it hadn't been for Don being able to navigate some very big changes in how we put all of this thing together. And one thing that you may not know is that this is Sergeant Major Paul Meyer's final workshop. He's going to be retiring. He's been serving as our workshop chairman for 9 years. He's worked on this conference every year since 94. That's 21 years. And when he was a member of the Marine Band, he performed at this workshop. He's given 30 years of faithful service to this nation. And we'd like to take a moment with your help to present him with a photograph so he can remember tonight's performance and just to say thank you. Please join us in thanking Sergeant Major Paul Meyer. Way back in 1983, a 15-year-old high school student from Creighton High School in St. Paul, Minnesota, saw an ad in the Tuba Journal that said that there was going to be a tuba conference being held in Washington, D.C., just for tuba players and euphonium players. Well, he wanted to go, and so he sat his parents down and tried to convince them that it would be okay. After all, Uncle Jim lived in nearby Potomac, Maryland, and if they would just put him on a plane, he could fly out and be at the conference. And so they did. And he flew to National Airport all by himself, and Uncle Jim picked him up and brought him over here to Fort Myer. He was amazed at everything he heard and saw, and he remembers meeting a couple of guys named Jeff Arwood and Marty Erickson, who took him under their wing and made sure he had money for lunch. Well, just a couple of years later, he returned to the Army Conference as a member of the President's Own United States Marine Band. And since those first fateful days, Pat has become the virtuosic ambassador of our generation, doing things on his tuba that no one else can do. He even painted his tuba, which no one else should do. Tonight he premieres a brand new tuba concerto hatched together with a composer, Rob Tehan, after they spent an afternoon eating tacos and concurring that the tuba has a lot more to say than what the current repertoire has to give. The composer wanted to add some of his own jazz and funk sousaphone background to Pat's untouchable virtuosity. The result is a collusion that will, as the composer puts it, challenge tuba players and bands alike to push beyond their training and become global musical citizens. Also, he wrote, "It rocks." Ladies and gentlemen, the world premiere of Rob Tehan's Collusion, performed by the incomparable Pat Sheridan.
Thank you. Wow. Just catching my breath here for a second on his behalf. Whew. You know, if you look in Webster under ridiculous, that would be Pat. Man, it's nice to be pushed that. Well, good evening. On behalf of our boss, Major General Bradley A. Becker, and all of the men and women of the U.S. Army Band, thank you for joining us tonight. We're fast approaching the end of a rich and full week of all things tuba and euphonium, and I must confess I'm a bit sad to see it go. It's been a lot of fun. Our workshop team is led by Sergeant Major Don Pallmeyer, worked throughout the year planning for the event, finding soloists, clinicians, ensembles, exhibitors, composers, contestants, and of course, plenty of music. I'd like to extend another thanks to Sergeant Major Pallmeyer and to Master Sergeant Neil Corwell for their years of honorable service, both to the Army and to this workshop. And I'd also like to acknowledge our dedicated Tuba Euphonium Workshop team and our outstanding support element, without whom none of this could happen. Our public affairs shop, to our librarians and arrangers, our resource management and supply sections, and absolutely our awesome technical support team for executing an outstanding workshop. So with those of you who I just mentioned, please stand if you're here so that we might express our thanks. Without those guys, it just doesn't happen. The soldier musicians of Pershing Zone help to connect the Army with Americans wherever they may be by performing over, actually, nearly 6,000 missions and reaching millions in live performances each year, as well as those many who are watching our web streams and our YouTube archived performances. It is through these performances that we represent all of the heroic men and women who stand around the world in defense of our freedom, and we're proud to do that. So, as a fitting end to this great week of music, we close our concert with two marches that feature the euphonium and the tuba, and we invite our guest soloists, that would be a cue, we invite our guest soloists and our sister service musicians to join us on stage for Carl King's The Melody Shop, and of course, Huffines' Them Basses. Thanks again for joining us and for your great support. Thank you.
Thank you.